Yes, I can take it right here, sir.
I can take it right here, sir.
Yes, you could make your approach and I can give the response.
All right. Well, first of all, good afternoon.
Good afternoon to you.
What's your name?
Courtney Gibson.
Courtney Gibson. All right. And what is you talking about today, Mr.
Okay,
Gibson?
Well, I am originally from Machiri's Northwest District.
Mm-hmm.
A community that I think had its clarity, its history, a community that paved ways for the economical crisis in this country where agriculture was concerned. And I am disappointed to the extent whereby I am left as an alien identified by my son. I'm an alien because even to proof of address seems to be a big problem in this country when we've got so much land without proper use. When the people only with the financial capabilities can acquire these things. I am disappointed to the extent being an ex-member of the Guyana Defense Force and left hanging upon a dam in front of Calgary Dam for me to be noticed. Coming from Natchez because it's been destroyed by soldiers, been destroyed by the government, it's been destroyed by so much of people who just get greedy, excessively greedy to the extent whereby nobody really cares about the poor man. I am on a dam on Mandela Avenue, Alpha Sovereign, this country, and buy a phone after coming to the interior,
mm-hmm.
and can't get a SIM because you got to get proof of address. Now, what is proof of address? Haven't I have to present a lot number? In order to say, well, this is my proof of address, or must I write a letter to the post office? And some entities still accept a letter from the post office as proof of address.
Yeah, you can go to the post office and get a letter there.
It's not a proof of address. It's not where I'm living. It's not where I am living. I am living at a lot. Matthews Northwest District doesn't have lot number.
From Matthews Ridge.
So coming to Georgetown after the village has been destroyed, the only thing goes on for the government in Matthews Northwest District is three police. One got killed a couple months ago. They might have replaced him because it's the kind of insignificance we're talking about. And about two nurses.
So when you say the village is destroyed,
it's the only village known to me that is suffering from total desertion, where everybody that knows the historical facts of the village move away, and nothing goes on but drinking and drunken. So the young people get caught up in the pursuit for gold, so everybody sports, everybody drink. Nothing goes on where the government is concerned. The agricultural status dropped to nothing. That provision from Georgetown got to go to Northwest District, where it never happened in the history of this country. The best designed village in the whole hemisphere, designed for management, and still being destroyed by greedy people.
You mean vegetables are going?
I am talking about provision.
Provisions?
The provision that used to float in from the seawall used to come from Northwest. The provision and the citrus used to float in from the seawall from Northwest.
They had so much.
So these things are the things that bother me, because remember that the essence of the family values destroyed, and everybody got to do's and don'ts. So every time a new government go in place, everybody got to readjust to suit this individual. You got to change your whole life. It's harder for me because the bank ain't gonna lend me a loan. I'm living in a plastic thing in the head of Calendar. Nobody visits me to say anything. I too big for join a line for a plot of land. I ain't prepared for pay for water because it's a land of many. To me, Guyana Water Operating Head said, water is life. Save it. If water is life, save it, and the database is less than 1 million people, then why can't you give the people of the country a little bit of water when we got so much natural resources? Why must I pay for water? Take some of the money from someplace else and put it to water, because we ain't got to run this pipe across the desert. It's a land of many. Don't give me the very clean one, but don't give me the very dirty one, so I need a little water. So they got plenty of things that bother me as an ex-member of the Guyana Defense Force that has not been respected. I think that, you know, we left hanging. And most of the ex-military posters end up with broken homes because you spend your entire life running behind the military's order.
So, and you don't feel they look out for you when you
No,
leave.
They had never up to the day before election. I was a person being on call. And I still living in a plastic on a stinking dam in the presence of Kirkland Dam.
So what do you think about the fact we have so much free land,
so much free land that got exorbitant prices? It's only people who dare with the soup dripping could buy these land. I can't. I come down to vote out of the interior. I come down to vote and I couldn't vote because the transfer time had passed. I went into GCOM. I asked them if they can put me on the volunteer team because I could not have afforded to go to Northwest so I could get a vote, and they refused. So I didn't get a vote. And so I ain't one of the person that put the stupidness were functioning up there. So this is the disappointed level that I just feel sometimes, you know, like at a movie where you're the old soldier and the system fucked up, do something. And it's easy for mobilize a couple old soldiers that are almost, they got a veterans organization, mm-hmm. that is only retarded and deleted old soldiers who just sit down and drink and set a beer can socialize, because it tells you nothing about your future after the army. Nobody carry on a mature dialogue. You see, but still they look at you from your outward perspective and assume who you may be, and they got no fucking idea.
So what's supposed to happen after you leave the army?
After you leave the army and you become a veteran. Mm-hmm. But then it is the interest of the army's veteran organization or the veteran organization to see that all military persons are at least harnessed, because remember they can do stunt, they can trip, and then you can isolate the individual and they got serious consequences. You're going to be isolated if you decide to rebel, because remember, you take me, you train me, you feed me, you destroy my family, I ain't got a firm family foundation, and there's it.
All right, and what else would you like to see happen?
Man, it's so much. It's going to take a long time. It's going to fill up the flash drive.
You got, it's going to take a long time. It's fine. You talk. You got
so it's so many things that you can put together that the disappointment roll beyond beyond people's comprehension. For instance, the level of crime. I am saying that we got over 5 or 6 ex-military personnel that run the fucking government. You understand? You can't evade crime. It's some cheap, hungry people, and all because of lack of employment. That caused most of the people for getting involved in cheap crime. Because if they got employment and it becomes compulsory, they got to work or they don't eat.
If land was made, some of the multitude of available land, if that was made available to people like yourself, do you think more people would start farming that land?
If more people
started
dying for farm, blah, like I only mentioned, the bank wouldn't lend me a loan and I'm in the position to finance it. Because the bank can lend you a loan and expect you're going to debt to mom. I say you're going to get it because you pass so much,
They give you a gratuity when you leave the army?
Nothing
like that. That's enough to do anything with?
No, because remember people keep thieving this money all the time. It depends on the circumstances because if you left the army. But then if you're living under economical constraints, why being a member of the Guyana Defense, then what's sense stay? Because they can't provide. I am a farmer by birth. And I can't get a piece of land for farm.
So you say you left the army because of economic constraints?
I left the army because I joined the army to see what was going on. My village were being destroyed by soldiers. I can show you, I got nephews that is the byproduct of rape. So when you see a soldier that left the army with a tribute, so you call you a fucking gentleman? Come on, talk to me. Me village, I am one of the persons who witnessed soldiers rape. We've been a time of 28 men fuck one woman. You ever hear about that? And there be stories that never come out of where I come from.
You serious?
Why am I joking?
I just got a camera.
I am in front of the camera.
Confirming, brother.
I am in front of the camera that is going to be publicized. This is paparazzi. Tomorrow, man, 2 bullets can shoot at me. I don't give a fuck.
So you are seen. This is what you talk
I
about.
I grew up knowing soldiers raping my village. That's why I joined the army. And I left now as an alien that I can't even get a SIM for by because I didn't get proof of address in Georgetown. Am I not a citizen of this country, coming from Matthews Natas district? I am not a legal, born citizen, genuine citizen of this country. So why is it that I got to get a proof of address when I went to school without the proof of address? I joined the army without the proof of address. I am a legal citizen without the proof of address. And now coming to Georgetown, I got to get a proof of address. Or you can't face up to me. Somebody advised me to apply for a farm. I hadn't wanted to apply for land in Georgetown because I wanted to go back home. But there's nothing to do home. Now, even though when you apply for a farm from the NDC or whatever the office deliver them and you can start filled up, they still state that you got to state your proof of address. Where can I put a proof of address when I live in no fucking place? So you, as an ex-military person, you're left exposed to the harassment of the police because remember, I am going to execute minimum or maximum force when it's necessary in order to stay alive because I am not being harnessed by the military nor the paramilitary forces. The police ain't gonna react to me and either save or prevent more crime than the police on a daily basis.
Example is Chinese.
Yeah, no, don't use them as a reference. I could become a formal target. Because remember, I'm stopping people from getting their fucking money. People are crazy. I live here. It's an obstacle. I could be next. You understand? So I live with them. So these are some of the things that they got people facing. And you know something? There's a big barrier from seeing the president. There's a big barrier from seeing Mr. Harmon. And these are people that we would have seen every day.
Especially on the campaign trail.
Yeah, these are people we would have seen every day on the campaign trail. The man that been close to neck, the Rasta man that been close to neck behind Mr. Grigio all the time, moving that sense, the man that trained me. When he called, I jumped like a fucking guinea pig. So I was connected to the computerized system long before computer communist country, because when these people call, whether I got passage or you got to catch a bus and tell the bus man, well, look, another fucking time they said.
So tell me, as a citizen, somebody on the ground, right, have you seen any change?
Yes, I seen some serious shit because I am disappointed in the people that promised me what they promised me. I am disappointed in the people with the experience that I've got as an ex-military person that's supposed to be identified as patriots, failing to function as patriots. I am disappointed in the ladies and the gentlemen in this country dying out, or that die out already, because it's any kind of thing turn man and woman. It's any kind of thing called, well, we got flow house, because we lose we homes. So if we lose the home, then the basic everyday respect had deteriorated so rapidly that nobody in this country right now got no regards to nobody. And if I'm saying lie, well, you could tell me a lie. Nobody in this country has no respect for nobody.
It's true, right? On a day-to-day basis.
On a day-to-day basis. You know, I end up being winded down at the end of the chain line, repairing old shoes upon a dam in plastic. If it wasn't for these Chinese,
5 minutes.
They just give me some light, which is one bulb. They just give me water, because I know the type of black man in the Kolima bin that want to get this little light and this water. But all for the cost of little protection. I could resign for no one until somebody call me if they want to get onto me, because you know this bothers me as an ex-military personnel. It bothers me to the core that I refuse to go look for a security guard, because you remember, I can't get a firearm and I need a firearm bad. I need a firearm bad.
But why do you think everybody needs a firearm?
Everybody does need a firearm.
Why do you need a firearm?
Why do I need a firearm? I got to face up with so much of people deep down in the jungle that United is witness so much of things. I am terrified. I am one of the persons with the training for and the capability to handle a firearm. You know how much people get firearms during the previous administration? People that never had no stability, people that ain't got no tolerance, people that can't control themselves, much less the firearm.
So you mean you need protection from those people?
From the government, I would need fucking protection.
Alright.
That would make it the merrier more for the don't give me.
And tell me a little more before you wind down about especially the young people in Northwest, in your community, and tell me what you would attribute to the breakdown, to the decay over the years, if this was a model community.
During the LFS Burnham regime, it used to be a problem for people from the outskirts enter Amerindian villages. You had to get permission from the captain. These days, like I said, people got no respect for nobody. So the key thing to Amerindians and their success with the Jai is what the governments keep taking away from them. The ability to farm and produce. The inflow of coastlanders without any proper infrastructure. So the people are being advantaged on a daily basis. The only level of entertainment there is alcohol. So it's poor, young, drunken people you got, and you can't find proper wife material because everybody drunk.
No jobs in the area.
You don't got jobs, unless in the private sector. The government ain't got jobs to accommodate the people. Most people are working because of the private sector. And then you got to toe the line, because remember, if you work with a man and you want to wash his shirt and you don't wash his shirt, you're fired.
And the gold, because I was told that gold is, you know, it's making a lot of money. To coastlanders, we see it as a very profitable industry, but you were talking earlier about some of the fallout of the gold mining industry in your communities, resulting in the sporting and the like. So I'm getting the impression money is being made on some level, but there is no guidance on perhaps how to spend, invest, what to do with it.
Correct me where I'm wrong. Like I said before, the people with the cultural knowledge, the people with the historical facts, the people with the zeal to carry on what was supposed to be a trend in the village that would make the village get its own day. Those are the people that were forced to migrate because of the lapse of the past, present, and present governments. We have seen all the governments in this country change from Arthur Chung right down. And every time a new somebody go into power, you got a different motive operandi, you got a different suggestion, you got different ideas, you got different laws that you got to start to facilitate.
No continuity in the progress.
Okay. You're the leader with one task, then we're going to shoot this track. Snake bite you. The man that's supposed to take the target is the man that can shine the light for everybody else to see. Instead of you get greedy and self-appeal and start caring only about you, and this will keep going on all the time. So the people in the Northwest are left alone. The only thing you hear about Region 1, the people in Machiru Northwest District, is when somebody murders somebody. Like when you hear the last time, one man stab up two police and kill one. Nothing else goes on. That tells you nothing about results in school, the tenable progress. Look, they're fighting with things from the road. Northwest used to produce so much manganese, the mine scrap, it's so much of things destroy. The people with the zeal for farming can't farm because then got transportation will bring the produce from Machiru Northwest to Joshua. I suffer in the process. I am left to identify as an alien in Georgetown because I can't even purchase myself a SIM for a phone. And then, you know, people can see you as who they feel like seeing you as. So here I am. Already solved the system and still you're fucked. Now these languages are not indecent language. I think they just fall. I know where I can say, but I really, really, really glad for the opportunity for this still here. And if the relevant people could hear this here, because I'm living on a dam, and I really believe that every legal Guyanese citizen that is patriotically inclined should attain a piece of land, either cash or credit. Both is by. Give me a piece of land and I can move from where there tomorrow morning, and I can build the next day even if it's plastic. But I need a piece of land because I can't go back home without money. The bank ain't gonna lend me a loan. And this is it.
So you're living down here for how long now?
This can come into a year or a couple months.
A year and a few months.
A year and a few months.
In a land with so much land.
And I got to get forced to squat because the process to acquire a piece of land is like water. You know, I don't buy water because I born and grow in an area where I never buy water. So it's hard for me to buy water in Central Georgia when I know the water they're selling me ain't no good. You see, when it too little bit for being a Guyanese for buy the amount of water that they're selling. I mean, later on, I got to control my children for how they bed. You see, I got to tell my children later, you could only use 2 cups of water, one for wet and one for rinse off.
Mm-hmm.
So these are the things that like really bother people and they don't give a fart. So I hadn't seen any progress. I didn't expect no progress in areas that they claim, but then remember that the level of hypocrisy still exists. The level of greed gets more because everybody wants to pull their own package.
Did you agree with the 50% raise the government gave themselves?
50% raise, what about me? I ain't get 10 cents. 50% raise, you already got. You already got. And you still give yourself 50% raise. And they still got people going to offer you money for favors. You see? So I got to work on every cent and you're going to calculate exactly how much you spend. For instance, taxi drivers, they can't carry home more than $3,500. It are there and it run down to that a taxi driver must not carry home more than $3,500. Even though he ain't working with nobody. That's how it run. As a shoemaker, you barely would make a 2,000 some days. The worst days sometimes shit. The past 2 days, I catch fish and I break 3 acres if I cook. Because I can't buy stupidness. There's a whole set of things going on and I'm disappointed because remember you can't see these people. It used to be so easy to see the president just the day before election and after then. I've been an ex-member of the Guyanese Defence Force who protect and watch this man back from so far, still can't see this man. And I got a plight because I am an alien. I just ride a motorcycle in the country without the license because I can't even get a SIM. So the police and me will got a problem because I got to move.
Right here.
Yeah, man, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so far.
Take care.